Yeah.
The question is, how composed are LMQ? Had they been able to sort of forget about that first loss? They need to take what they've learned from the pick ban phase from last time and come into this one with a fresh game plan. They're not going to ban out any AD carries themselves, I'm quite sure.
Yeah, absolutely. But C9T is still looking at maybe the early Lucian grab. Kate Twitch being removed says, you know, Vasili, you're going to have the first rotation or early rotation Lucian if you want this one. LMQ actually switching their bans a fair bit. The Zig still a carryover. The Soraka, or yeah, the Eve still the ban, but they've added Shyvana here. But it's first pick Soraka here for Cloud9 Tempest. LMQ, Lucian's a big one that's still up. Of course, Kha'Zix is down, but they might not want to go for that team fight cop against Soraka.
Yeah. And like I said before, I really like that one when you're going up against the farm heavy mid laner, just because you can add that global pressure. Looks like Cloud9 definitely valued that, even though he had a hard time keeping up in CS, which most people do against Xiao Wei Xiao.
Yeah.
A lot of that too, you know, there was several jungle ganks towards mid, putting extra pressure on them.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're gonna see what LMQ does with their few choices in this one. Corki still available, Graves still available, two picks that weren't banned in this champ select. The Elise steal, though, might be pretty valuable, of course. Now with two junglers banned, you can start pushing people farther and farther down their champ pools. LMQ, they're not rushing any of that. Hovering Morgana right now, saying, you know, Glebe had too good of a game on it last time. Let's remove some of these defensive picks here that C9 wanted.
And remember, the other thing that has changed here is that LMQ now have the last say in a counter pick.
True.
They can get a hard counter pick in any lane that they want. They could even save that for their AD carry for Vasili to make sure that he is in a matchup that he feels comfortable in. Likewise, they could also go for that level one invade. They could go for which would afford them a 2-1 lane swap. Since they are on purple side, that's expected actually a lot from a lot of teams.
We'll see what they do with this one. Of course, Morgana, Elise, already talked about that one. Lucian, pretty much auto-locked for Cloud9 Tempest, though. We will have to see what Yasuke wants to play for his top lane. The Karma, though, for the matchup. So, Karma Lucian versus Morgana X in the bottom lane.
I kind of like this Morgana here, or this Karma here, because it's a good champion for putting somebody on tilt. Who's someone who's already maybe a little bit unstable from the last fight. If you come out level 1, you land your Mantra Q onto an AD carry as they're coming to lane.
He's like 100 health.
That can be devastating to them.
Yeah.
And that can throw off their entire early laning phase.
Yeah. Well, we'll see. LMQ not really changing their comp up too much, but they grabbed the Graves that was banned before. The Lucian Steel going to let him pick his next pick anyway. The Orianna still coming through in the mid lane. So, you know, LMQ and I guess C9T as well, happy with the mid lane matchup as it went last time.
Yeah.
Sure, there were 50 minions, but the global pressure was nice here for Bishu. Going to be new AD carries this one, new supports as well. And now C9T have to say, okay, what's our top laner? It's got to be a blind pick.
Yeah. The other thing about playing against that Soraka is that LMQ will now be expecting it. I don't think Vasili will be opting into those duels without calculating in the wish from now on, because he was taught that lesson several times last game.
Yeah.
And I think that everybody on LMQ has had time to go over how are we going to deal with Soraka, because they probably expected Soraka to be taken again since they didn't ban her out. They should be able to deal with her this time around. The thing is, what Hai talked about, she's so good in team fights. And again, they've got Graves and Orianna here, pretty team fighty champions right there that they're looking for with their carries. So it is a little bit dangerous.
Well, the interesting thing is Cloud9 Tempest, actually, I feel like they upped their ability to withstand an area of effect team. You've just added Karma, who can Mantra Inspire and just get this gigantic AoE shield. You've got Ryze, who's also going to build tanky around 25-30 minutes in that top lane as well. Jungle Xin Zhao also can disrupt some of that combo, but also be a tank in the front line. So C9T, in a lot of ways, a very similar composition. Defensive, rely on the AD carry, shield everyone up, heal them up. LMQ is still a team fight team.
The big change here, though, this time around, C9T looks like they're going a little bit more late game. Xin Zhao is actually, with Feral Flare, is actually more of like a late game jungler now. He's very strong late game if you can get those stacks on Feral Flare.
Yeah.
He's still pretty good early. You do sacrifice a little bit of early game dueling power when you go with the Wriggles. It's an investment. You're waiting for that return on your investment later. But especially with the Ryze lock-in, I think Cloud9 Tempest are going to be playing pretty defensively in the opener for this game and playing more reactively to what LMQ are bringing, because they've got the Elise, they've got the Renekton, they're going to be looking to make their moves earlier, and they've got the Graves too, who has a lot of bursts for an AD carry.
Yeah, absolutely. So there's going to be some interesting things to watch for then, is how good are the catches, the Dark Bonding. We saw how good they were from Glebe Garbu. We'll see if Moore lands a bunch for himself, because that'll open up the opportunities. Again, I think you're right with the Renekton, Elise, those two have so much playmaking potential that LMQ, we tout them largely as an early game team who's very good at converting that early lead into a siege in like a 25-minute close to the game.
Mm-hmm.
C9T didn't let that happen in game one here, but game two, that's always the risk for LMQ. You land a couple of good ganks, and they've been very good at crushing the game once it happens.
And LMQ should be more comfortable this time around. Ackerman's on Renekton. They've got Graves for Vasili. It looks like they are going to be pretty happy with the squad that they have right now. And they should have control of those early dragons. With the team that they've got right now, I think the early dragons, if there are team fights around them, will probably go towards LMQ's side. So Cloud9 might even be looking to give those up.
Yeah.
And as I said, play a little bit more defensively early. We'll have to see what kind of stuff Ackerman can do since this is the new Renekton. Taking a little bit of power off of his ultimate early. However, it scales up. Towards the late game a little bit better now.
Yeah, exactly. Bigger power spike at 16 for him, weaker at 6 and 11. And I actually want to kind of pay attention to what you talked about with the dragon fights there as well, because, C9T, more of a late game scaler. They don't want to necessarily do the dragon fights, but then what do they do when LMQ goes for dragons? If LMQ just does a rotation as opposed to like a pick into a dragon?
Yeah, Ryze is not like a great shoving champion, so it's not like he can answer with a turret himself. Valid point.
So I want to see what these guys do with this one. Sorok at least can push. We'll see if that combos up.
One ward each for the supports.
Fun minor fact, Ryze and Soraka both have magic resist shreds. We might see them actually get some very serious damage off during a fight if it goes on a bit long. And with, I mean, C9T being generally tanky, having heals and whatnot, that could be a real possibility. Also, Altec has teleport.
Aha! That's like, I was just talking about how in solo queue, when I have to play a role I'm not comfortable with now, I always take teleport because when I lose my trade, then you just teleport back to lane.
Mm-hmm.
You can actually use that to increase your advantage here. And we see it a lot of times actually on Lucian, teleport in lane. He can go for the early trades, and even if he comes out behind on the trades, he'll be able to back and make a purchase, returning very quickly, and sometimes he can even capitalize on that right after getting back.
We'll see what they find with this one, because right now, going to be the teams waiting around for a little bit.
Definitely gives them a great late game advantage, too. Two teleports for them. Should have very strong map control. It also means that they are going to be defending their turrets tooth and nail. They want to keep their outer turrets up as long as possible, because that is the best way to be using your teleports nowadays. Getting back to the outer turrets, reducing that cooldown by 100.
There's actually one thing I want to think about with those TPs, though. Is that LMQ has three, like, pretty easy to land long range skill shot CCs. Shockwave, Cocoon, Dark Binding.
Uh-huh.
If you TP onto a turret, you're gonna go into a predestined spot in front of it. And if you learn those timings, you're gonna fall into a Dark Binding immediately.
We did just see last game how Cloud9 and Tempest were not able to land the bind on Ackerman though, right when he teleported in.
Mm-hmm.
You do have to get used to it.
So we'll see what these guys can do with this one. Mid lane going to be the early push actually for Xiaowei. Xiao puts his early trinket ward to the top side of the mid lane. Watches the ramp in towards his red jungle. It's going to actually help keep No Name safe on top of that one. So
yeah. This matchup is very, very interesting between Ryze and Renekton because Ryze can bully him early. However, Renekton has the all-in potential. And when junglers come, it's not if they come, it's when they come.
Mm-hmm.
This top lane matchup can be swung very quickly either way. The all-in, as I said, is definitely there for Renekton. If Ryze is trying to bully you and shove you, and he's in your face, then he's extended in the lane. If he doesn't have the coverage, you can make him pay for it. And once Renekton gets the lead, then he can all-in over and over. But it looks like Hizuki...
Well, they've already started the fight. The Ignite used by Ackerman, he is not quite level 2. Gets it now. That might have been the damage he needed to get the kill. But it's going to be health... Biscuits chugged by Yazuki to keep him alive.
And it doesn't look like Elise will be making the early trip top. Starting red, ending her route down bottom. Kez looking for the early invade here. He's going to get it just after the nick of time. Oh, it was even an early smite too. Level 3 Elise.
Well, it forces the flash, the repel up to the wolf camp as well. He's going to be safe with that one. The quick escape, both buffs.
Very quick reactions there from No Name. Well played by him. Didn't waste any time trying to flash in range of those wolves.
Well, that was nicely played. So No Name is going to be in good shape. Altec actually taking a bit of buckshot to the face. Got to be a little careful on that one, but... Karma Lucian has a lot of poke potential.
And there goes No Name. After escaping that, he goes immediately top. As I said, he ended his route down bottom, but he went straight for this Ryze because Ryze is overextending. He's trying to get the most out of his early game advantage over Renekton. Now he might pay for it.
See what they can find. There's going to be the stun. The flash. Cocoon is not going to land. Yasuki, the repel comes in. His flash is down, though. It's going to be enough damage for LMQ. Q comes out. That's the red buff tick. Yes, it is. First blood, 4 minutes 15 into the game.
That was a little greedy by No Name. Not immediately following up the Renekton stun with his cocoon. He opted for the Q first.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't cost them, though. They still get the kill. They still are able to swing that fight back in to Renekton's favor. He didn't get the kill, though. So Renekton, he's definitely going to be looking for more all-ins.
Yeah.
Pretty early here.
Well, teleport used by Yasuki to get himself back to the lane. Of course, no such teleport for Ackerman. But No Name is actually already waiting to re-gank the top lane now that TP's been used. But Kez is going to wait in the wings as well.
That's why I said when jungler intervention happens top, because this matchup here is explosive. Yasuki's actually trying to freeze this wave in front of his turret, so he takes a little bit of damage from the cannon minion. You can see it almost took off 100 HP there. He has gone tier, so still just as squishy as before.
And he's going to try to last hit the cannon. It's actually not using much mana to last hit, which is interesting, because it won't let him charge his tier very quickly by doing this, but Elise shows up saying, hey, you know, we want to push you off the turret. Ackerman, he's actually going to land the stun on this one. This is not good for Yasuki. Big damage comes through. Kill picked up. Kez going to try to answer back towards Ackerman. He will pick up the trade kill. The flash stun onto No Name, but there's too many minions there. He's not going to stop him.
Yeah, that was an interesting repel at the end. But yeah, Kez is able to answer a kill this time. He was farming the jungle there, so not there initially. But as I said, looking for more all-ins from Renekton. He's trying to take advantage of the early mana building phase of Ryze. They did it decently there, and you could also tell that No Name learned his lesson from last time. Immediate cocoon after the stun. Didn't wait for it. Didn't give Ryze any time in between there.
Yeah. And just honestly so well played overall. The slice and dice past the turret to set up the gank. Kez had waited, but said, you know what? I don't think they're going to dive you. And as soon as he turned around, LMQ had gone in.
Izuki's got a ward, and he places it right in No Name's face. So No Name knows there is a ward here. Going to go sweep it out.
At least it's going to be a 2-minute sweeper cooldown. So if he places the real site ward down, maybe Yasuki will be safe on this one.
That's the bait ward?
Yeah, the trinket ward. We might as well.
It's like
only worth 10 gold this early. Screw it.
All right, Kez also returning here, so.
There it is. He put the real ward down. It got pinged, actually. No Name knew, or Ackerman knew about that.
This is a big wave they have to work with, too. Would Cloud9 actually go for a dive on Renekton here? He's not level 6.
No 6, no flash.
Soraka's coming in. They are going for the dive. Bishu's going to back him up with the heals. Good call by Ackerman to back off.
Yeah, he's going to get well out of range. No Name waiting in the wings as well. Now, if they know Soraka's missing, though, they won't dive the 2v3 back in the turret. Actually, Ackerman staying in experience. The dive goes in there. There's the jump, the knockup into the air as well. Yasuki taking turret. I got forced to run back, gets Wish onto him. But there comes Elise. The heal comes through. No Name still trying for this one, but Yasuki with a summoner heal stays alive. They find the first kill. Now Ackerman is 6. Get some health back from Cole the Meek. C9T, they're not going to go for more.
And Bishu punishing Xiao Wei Xiao for his inability to roam. Xiao Wei Xiao always focuses so much on farm. He stays there 100% of the time, even though, like you said, they call Soraka missing. No Name gets a little bit baited by himself, getting his target so low there, trying to kill Yasuki. Bishu was in the area still and was able to rejoin the fight.
Yeah, Wish, Astral Blessing, and Summoner Heal, all of them combined, was Captain Planet and enough damage. The fight again, Ackerman looking for Yasuki. Last of Ignite, not going to kill him, but the chase still going. Kez, not in a good spot, taking damage
from
Dominus.
He's got Empowered Strike.
Empowered Q, the stun, not quite in range, goes for the slow though, gets stunned up, finds the trade kill though, and that's actually advantage C9T.
Yeah, not worth.
With Yasuki getting the kill.
The only thing that he does have in his favor is that the wave's pushing towards his turret still. So it will be there when he gets back, and Ryze will continue to have to extend.
It's going to be the quick recall there for Ryze with the summoner teleport available if he wants it. No Name, pink wards shared in that brush. You know, that one's not going to live long for LMQ. But for now, it's going to be a bit of slight control. Mm-hmm. Waiting towards the mid lane. Bishu has to know about this. His flash is down, which means if Xiao Wei Xiao finds a shockwave, it's grim for Soraka.
Yeah, so the roaming does cost him NCS. However, he's able to play pretty defensively, and even being down 20, being able to turn around that top lane fight was definitely important for them.
This is good by LMQ. They've stopped multiple recalls from C9T, and with the shove in the mid lane, especially with Bishu grabbing blue buff, LMQ just goes for a dragon straight up with four people. No one's going to stop them. It's going to be a quick gold lead. 12.2, 12.9, 700 gold dragon.
Kez reclaims the Pixel Bush for Cloud9. And yeah, that is another advantage of the minion focus that Xiao Wei Xiao has. Shoving in the lane, they're able to time it very well to get Dragon. Kez will find out that it's gone.
And blue buff taken away as well, so both mid laners going to hold blue buff for the next few minutes. Ooh. As they stay in the lane. Altec, Vamp Scepter, the same for Vasili, who's having a much better game.
The
5 CS difference.
The level 6 Graves. I'm always really interested to see if they can get the combo down for a level 6 Graves, especially with the buffs.
There's the ulti, and Altec's going to have to flash for that one. Quick cooldown exchange.
Yeah, exactly. Good good use of his flash. That would have been his death there. Ackerman, though, had shoved up the lane, so Yuzuki gets some pre-farm time here. And it looks like the junglers have decided they're bored with this top lane. Not returning there.
Yeah.
After so much attention paid bottom.
They figured they've both won. Both junglers are, or both top laners are 1-2-2. So it's like, yeah, we set you behind. Should be enough, right? We'll see. Ackerman looking for a bit of a trade. Damage coming back and forth.
I like
back in the tier.
I like the early boots upgrade from Yuzuki, so that he can kite Renekton more effectively. Because really, the only thing he's worried about is the all-in from Renekton while he's trying to build his mana up. And that move speed is definitely a very valuable defensive tool.
Yeah, Ackerman, of course, rushing the Spectre's Cowl just to regenerate all the periodic harass that Ryze puts towards him. Only kind of goes in when he can land the Empowered Q and get his health back for the trade.
Jungler's waiting in the wings once again.
That's a good bit of damage. Kez is around, though. The flash in, the dash not quite in range. Kez doesn't have fast enough movement speed to catch Ackerman.
A little bit of a miscalculation there from Kez is going to cost him because Elise has seen the jungler attention. With Ryze recalling, though, really all they can get is some shove under the turret.
Not going to be too much then. It's going to be the teleport up as well again already. Wow. And one of the cool things about Ryze is you typically go deep enough into the utility tree. You get another 10% CDR in that, dropping your summoner spell to a full, just even 3-minute teleport.
Looks like we might have a collision of junglers once again. Noname spends a lot of time sitting in these top bushes, though.
That's been his style. I mean, 26 minions is very, very low at 11 and a half minutes. He's just there for the ganks. 2-1 on himself, early Sork shoes.
When someone stays around with this low HP, by the way, even at his turret like Ryze like this, you have to be thinking that he's waiting for a counter gank here.
And well, there's the attempt. Empowered stun into a lot of damage. Ulti comes by. Ackerman does take aggro, but he gets away with the flash safely. Naga from Kez has big damage.
Got his flash up.
Can he find much more? Dashes into flash over the wall, but here comes Vishu. Ackerman not in a good spot for himself. Puts the Q down. One more Q. Dashes the wall and gets out safely.
Godlike move. Able to draw Bishu away from the mid lane and escape with his life. Great move here. Xiaowei Xiao is going to take a lot of health off of that. Turn the teleport in down bottom.
And comes Ryze in the back. Vasili's got nowhere to go. Didn't even need to show up. Now it's all about Morgana. Goes in towards the mid lane. Binding onto Glebe. Does have flash.
Yuzuki doesn't even get to play. He used his teleport to get down here.
He's trying.
He definitely wants a piece of Morgana.
Soraka shows up. It's going to be the ulti popped as well. Bishu has to be a little bit careful in this one, but Kez comes into the wings as well. Ooh, the summoning, he'll keep him safe. The knockout comes by. Ryze finally gets a piece. Yazuki grabs the kill for that one. 4.5 minute summoner cooldown. He's going to go back up to the top lane.
All right, so that will be, as you said, the full length duration on teleport. So no more free backs for Yuzuki in the top lane. And he's still just with mostly pure mana build here.
But he's stacking. It's going to keep Ackerman, going up. Actually,
no,
doing really good damage here.
Bought.
Here comes the chase. Ulti is down on all sides. No flash. Ackerman dodges. Lands the double dash. Nice play. Oh,
yep.
The flash. He's not done. Q. E. One more spell. Picks up Ackerman. Yazuki 1v1.
Pretty greedy there.
Yeah.
From Ackerman. He had a lot of money, too. They hadn't even gone back to purchase. He gets a whole Banshee's Veil completion. Good move from Yazuki, though. Doesn't give up on the chase, even though it was a great slice and dice juke by Ackerman. Follows him with the flash. Pretty good roam from Yuzuki.
Right in the mid lane.
At his mid.
Oh, they're out
self.
Of mana. Never mind. They're out of mana. I got excited for nothing.
Yeah, yeah.
You identified that one. I'm used to Zed, where it doesn't matter. Never has mana. Doesn't seem to stop him much at all.
I have to also point out that Kez has not gone with the Wriggles, which is very common with Xin Cao here. Now, Lizard Elder does give you more early game impact. Definitely higher impact ganks that he's going to have, but he hasn't really gotten an edge in the fights that he's been in even with that item. So that might he might be regretting not going with the Wriggles into Flare of Flare later in the game.
I don't think anyone would ever sell that and like rebuy Wriggles later. I don't think that ever makes sense.
No, because you need to be stacking it up from the beginning of the game.
Yeah, yeah. Buying like a 35-minute Wriggles doesn't help, even if it instant combines.
That is a terrible idea if you've ever had one.
Okay, well, that's why I posed it, didn't say you should.
That's good.
I was like, hey, what about this thing? And you're like, no.
We're
like,
working, okay. Working through the thought process right now.
I usually just say things live. That's I don't think them through when I commentate.
It was good.
It's like, you know, AD carry Elise, great build, right?
Well,
Infinity Edge.
He actually does not even have a Dorance this time around, which would be the common one. Freeze here for the bottom lane, trying to keep that on their sides. We have not really seen a lot of action bottom. Seems like Vasily does not want to make any more mistakes down bottom, so he hasn't all-ined anymore. He's very wary of the Wish from Soraka. Does not want to go into one of those fights where his opponent has an extra heal to call for, even though he is Graves with that giant burst damage. Altec gets fine.
That's a jump to there's no name though. Black Shield is on, keeps him safe and not in the air. The dash is two-man shotgun comes in. Wish comes by early. The knock and the attempt towards Xiao Wei Xiao. Nice ulti from Moore. He's gonna get the stuns and Graves ulti comes by as well. Kill picked up on towards Kez. Gonna be another kill picked up
the
White!
Issue.
The kill back though from the White. Moore trying to run away. Gleeb and Altec still on the chase though. Very low health for us. Vasily, some nice burst. Gets the shield as well. Gleeb forced to run away. Flashes action to keep himself safe. Altec goes in. Finds Xiao Wei Xiao. Looks for more now. Can he get it? One more attack. No. The puddle actually claims it up. One for one. And now Gleeb in the wrong spot of town. Yazuki waits in a ward to get him safety.
Yuzuki's trying to get him a way out here, but I don't think he's going to be able to scare up Ackerman with the Banshee's Veil.
Empowered W going to heal him a little bit actually. That
Yuzuki, where have you gone?
Yeah, he could have re-imprisoned someone.
He definitely could have stayed in there. I don't think he was expecting Gleeb to use his summoner heal. I think that was some miscommunication there from C9.
Yeah.
Yuzuki just kind of baits him there.
Yeah. Well, it's okay. He's rise. It's going to be all right.
All right, yeah, let's look at this one more time because there's a great shockwave, but then this is the heal power. The Soraka mid-game team fights chasing everybody off with the star call, and Vasily comes in with that burst. We finally get to see it. White gets his vengeance onto No Name there, finishing him off. And Altec decides to spend Flash for a kill onto Xiao Wei Xiao. Eh, it's okay. If he could get two, then it would definitely be worth.
Yeah, got close, but Blue Buff went to more. Actually, another catch now. Kez not in the best shape of his life right here. Can he dodge with a Dark Binding? No, gets cocooned as well. Big damage comes through. Kill picked up for No Name in this one. Gleeb now in the mix, but there comes a Shockwave. Another two men. This is big for LMQ. They're going to find Yazuki. They're going to find even more on this one. Bishu's got nowhere to go. He's going to fall. Another three kills, LMQ, and control over Dragon.
The mid-game team fights around Dragon that LMQ want because they've got the Renekton. Ryze right now still scaling up. They're getting their advantages here. I think C9 are pushing it a little too much around the Dragon Pit early. I didn't think that was going to be their plan coming into this one.
Altec trying to fight Vasily though. Gleeb Webber not far away. There's the Black Shield as well, and more actually now in the wrong spot. Big dash in. Altec finds the kill. The counterattack now from Vasily dives in. The big damage.
The duel!
One hit the flash. Vasily gets the kill picked up. Now Gleeb chased down by Ackerman. This could be very bad for the support. Karma puts a ward down. Teleport comes in. He's trying to keep his team alive. Again, the Empowered W keeping his health in a decent spot. Here comes Ryze. Is it enough damage? Ackerman does not have much, but he does have Flash. One hit from dead. Flashing away. Minion damage not going to be enough. The Flash, the Rune Prism.
Oh!
So he goes down. More spells. Yazuki double kill. Ryze pulling.
And now they're closing on Xiao Xiao, but they don't know No Name's in the bush.
Well, the ulti comes across, Kez gets stunned, Bishu's around though. I don't know if Kez is really going to die here. Great shockwave again from Xiao Wei Xiao. No Name into the air. Looks for Gleeb, but the shield does not keep him alive. Kill picked up for No Name, making it a worth it trade anyway. Cocoon comes through, sure to be a kill. Bishu gets that one. These teams are constantly trading kills.
Yeah, Gleeb should not have walked into that repel circle from Elise. But man, all right, Vasily gets his vengeance on Altec this time around. He's one hit away. He wins the duel in the end. Great damage onto Moore from Altec, so he gets a kill first. But then Vasily just comes out ahead, flashing over to get the last shot, and Ackerman goes a little too deep.
You know, Altec wasted a cooldown there. He dash Q'd instead of dash auto-attacking, which would have killed Morgana.
Yeah, get that extra passive. Yuzuki, though, does not give up on the fight and ends up claiming the blue buff. So that's good. Another pretty big win.
Yeah, actually, you know, even though he's been on the correct side of the map for it, they've always given blue buff to Soraka, not to the Ryze. Mm-hmm. For the mid lane matchup, saying Yasuke, you just build some mana, stick it out for a while. He's now going towards Banshees or Spectre's Cowl. I would probably guess Banshees, actually. Or Banshees or Spirit Visage. I know Visage is nice on Ryze.
Yeah.
I feel like Anti-Shockwave is more important.
And the blue buff is really good for him, especially since he isn't building early cooldown reduction. Yeah. Ryze loves cooldown reduction, and he's not getting it early out of this build that he's going for.
Yeah.
With scaling and then magic resist, so.
Not even a glacial.
He's definitely very happy to get this blue buff.
So he's going to keep the spam going. Tier's got to be pretty much stacked by this point. Even still, though, he's. Okay, yeah, there's a Q coming out, but he's using a lot of auto attacks in general in lane, keeping his mana pool fairly high.
And as you said, there is a very substantial amount of magic damage shred or magic resistance shred from the Ryze Soraka combo moving towards late. So even Karma will be hitting pretty hard.
Mm-hmm. And you're going to see the...
Look at this, the bush gank here. Duo squad, there's no flash for Yuzuki.
All right, can he dodge the cocoon? No, he walks back into it. The stun going to come in for Ryze as well. But now the spell vamp chain, big AoE. Spiderling's going to drop down rather quickly, actually. Gets the damage back down. Yeah, No Name couldn't handle that.
Up comes Xin Cao as well. They want to make him answer. There is no turret here. Boots of Mobility.
Flash dive in. Nice point blank stun, but now Ackerman going to get knocked into the air by Xin Zhao. Should be a bit more damage. Dashes forward again. Gets another slow. Ackerman pops the ulti. Will have an empowered stun if he wants it. The Rune Prison keeping him in good shape. Kez gets the kill credit. 2, 3, and 5. Leave Glarbu stunned up right there. Shotgun's going to be soon as well. Big damage comes through. Vasili gets the kill credit.
Yeah, 2 big damage AoEs used to kill off 1 lonely little support here. That is going to give them control around the bottom turret, though. Altec and Bisou can defend it. How many backs can they stop, though? Because there's a great shove up top by Kez and Yuzuki.
Yeah, they'll need their next wave before it really goes down, but they're going to get good damage in this one. Altec going to commit to this one. Actually, no, they're going to stay a little bit. No Name is actually trying to defend top lane. Vasili face checking, though, against Altec. Top turret goes down, but here goes the battle. No ulti for Graves, but big damage. Soraka heal doesn't come in time. The 10% crit did enough damage. Wish was on cooldown. He didn't think he had to flash for that one. Bisou pushed Vasili away, but a great kill.
He had flash and heal. Yuzuki now under pressure.
Taking a whole bunch of pain. The burst comes back across towards No Name, but it's not going to be enough. More helping out with the black shield. Actually gets the kill credit.
These are exciting games. Kills all over the map here. Everyone not hesitating to go for those duels.
I'm going to see Bisou trying to auto attack with stale bananas. Only does so much damage. Vasili,
why are they stale?
Because they've been chilling out in someone's grip for so long out in the sun.
But bananas don't get stale. They get mushy.
Mushy bananas coming in. Altec with the teleport to a minion. Just wanted to use the globals on Vasili and does. Kill picked up by Bisou. Soraka wasn't enough.
The teleport Altec comes in. He doesn't have that combat summoner, but he
would have helped him before.
He's able to teleport in. Yeah, it would have helped him before.
Well, 3-3-3 on Lucian versus 6-3-3 on Graves. You know, hasn't seen Graves much in a while. Some of that's going to be the rune chain, and some of it going to be the kind of team fight choice here for LMQ. But Graves kind of back in the mix. The buff's helping, of course, as well.
Vasili definitely looking like he's got his confidence back now, too. After those first couple team fight kills, he'll probably start playing more aggressive now. And that is what LMQ need. They've got a lot of power focused on him, and they need that burst damage from Graves for the team fight because they want to combo it with the Shockwave. Try and just out-damage all the heals that Bisou's going to be putting out.
Yeah, you see him try to push through on a Xiao Wei Xiao Dragon. Up now in 20 seconds. Teleport is available for Ryze, whereas Ackerman never even brought it on Renekton. So C9T play a bit of a freeze
versus
Yuzuki's
Dragon. Freezing up there. Yeah, I think he's freezing up there, so they probably won't contest it. And I don't think they should. Oh, no! That's terrible for him.
Dark Binding hits as well, but gets the Mikhail's Crucible to stay alive for this one. Gonna dash back in. Tries to kill some Spiderlings, doesn't quite. LMQ, though, 5 strong, are going for this Dragon. No objectives available except for that mid lane outer turret, which is now getting pushed by Bisou. Dragon goes down fast. Glebe, not going to be the range for the steal. Red team, LMQ, picks up Dragon.
You have to be worried about getting cut off here when you go for this trade of the mid turret, because they're only 4 man.
Moore has flash. There's the dissonance. Good silence in. He's going to look for it. Finds it onto Bisou. The engage from Kez. Big damage. In comes the teleport. This is the fight to watch for. Big heals. Kez still alive. Shockwave lands onto a few. Kez is going down 1-0 so far. More pushed away into the back lines. Altec does not find anything. He goes down, chasing down Vasily. LMQ looking for more of the 2-for-0 so far. They now find Yazaki. He's trying to put damage towards Noname. Will follow, though, 3-for-0 plus Dragon.
See, it's so often. Teams have the right idea. Yeah, we want to trade an objective for this Dragon we're giving up, but they don't remember about their positioning. After Dragon's down, you got to worry about the exit route. And Moore didn't even have to flash in range for that one. He just walked up to them to force this fight. Exactly the fight that LMQ wants. They've got much more power right now. They're going to get outscaled later, but they get the fight they need now. Altec actually going in for the duel with Vasily, 2-1.
Yeah.
Wei Xiao's definitely going to have his say in that fight this time around. Meanwhile, Ackerman, who's actually a tank, was tanking up the rest of Cloud9.
Yeah. That felt like a really bad misplay by Altec, though, to go and try to dive the AD carry.
Yeah, both of these AD carries look like they get kind of on tilt pretty easily.
Mm-hmm.
Last time around, it was Vasily. This time, though, Altec getting a little bloodthirsty.
Yeah. So one thing you mentioned during that fight as well was the fact that Ackerman is a big tank right now on Renekton, right?
Yeah.
His not only his offensive build. Item is Hex Drinker.
Yeah, not his usual build, getting that Tiamat. So,
but
I do like it, though, because that's what they need. They need to win these mid-game team fights and increase their lead.
Yeah.
They've done just that, though. Awarded Baron after that last one.
Yeah, big lead. LMQ up 6,500 gold. But the corollary to that point, though, is corollary is not the word for it, is that Kez is barely starting his tank stats. Boots Mobility, Elder Lizard, tried to cash in on early ganks, had mixed success, certainly not the same success that Noname has, who's 5, 3, and 7.
Mm-hmm.
But there's no real great durability items yet for this Xin Zhao on the front line. You saw him get like a 4-man ulti and still got popped, despite Soraka heals.
Yeah, he's pretty squishy. And since he didn't go Pharah Flare, it's not going to be that endgame impact that they're looking for. Won't really have that objective control quite as much. But they do have a Ryze on their team, who has scaled pretty nicely.
Yeah, 5, 6, and 3. A lot of deaths, but Yazaki having his presence in fights. The 4, 2, and 2. Soraka also has the Ryze Crystal Scepter done, going towards the Randuin's next. Standard par for the course for that stuff. The siege potential. LMQ get rid of some wards. They put one down for themselves as well. We don't know that Noname's in that brush right here. Wave clear for Altec. Going to buy another 30 seconds for this turret. Z9T doing what they can to wait out the Baron buff.
Bishu with the blue buff. Ooh. Going to be able to sustain up pretty well, even against Baroned up LMQ here. LMQ might go for the dive on the next wave. Vasily does have his combo of Bloodthirster plus Last Whisper now, so it's definitely hard-hitting ulti combo from him.
They found some damage on the Glebe. Gonna be the gold picked up there for more pretty easily. Mid lane not doing much, but the bottom lane, big damage coming through. Down to half HP, this second tier turret. C9T, they are missing a couple ultimates. The binding on the Kez, not gonna be enough. They go in for this one. Big damage, jungler gets the Mikhails. The Wish comes by as well. Fight still coming in. Repel into the air, the fight now. Here we go, the Shockwave not gonna land on anything. The Kez gets the disengage. Now LMQ maybe are overextended. Going to be any re-engaged by C9T.
They've used all their AoE burst, and C9 were able to live through it with all the heals and burning two flashes.
Another bind, though. Yazaki, wow. Big damage on a Ryze.
Ryze is going to start building just tank now, though, because he's fully scaled up his Rod, and he's fully scaled up his Seraph's Embrace. So both of those mana items he's waiting for have completed finally for him. From now on, he's going to be buying a lot more resistances.
One thing I actually want to see, really on both sides actually, is an Aegis to come through.
Mm-hmm.
Both teams have significant AoE, especially the Locket.
Yeah.
A lot of area effect damage, and especially area effect magic damage.
There is an Aegis already there.
Good.
For Noname.
Noname playing the team one. That item, I don't see it right now for C9T, but I think that would be a big benefit to them. Just add even more to the area of effect durability. And get through the big burst. But of course, Vasily does have some good follow-up there. Three big completed items. He's up a Last Whisper over Altec right there. Very huge difference between these AD carries.
Yeah, and he looks like he's going towards Infinity Edge next, too. Mm-hmm. So four offense item graves towards the end game. They're going to put a lot of weight in the burst from Vasily. Now, Graves, pretty short range.
Mm-hmm.
He'll usually be getting a defensive item. Probably will be after that fourth item, I guess.
And the thing is, there's so much threat by his team anyway. Ackerman going in, the shockwaves and all that. Morgana also being a ticking clock where, like, kill her in 4 seconds or she stuns your team.
Yeah, a lot of AoE CC to help him out.
There's people pulling attention, people stunning the enemy lineup. He's just not really taking damage. Vasily, 7, 3, and 5, having such a great game on Graves right here. Kind of warranted that ban from game one. You see what he can do with this champion. And I also got to say, the TP from Altec He's actually kind of backfiring a bit.
Yeah.
The lack of heal made him lose a couple of duels. He also made some bad choice swing surprise. It worked once in a while. I actually saw him get a kill because of it. But I wonder what happened if he actually had a little bit more lane pressure, could win more of his fights. G9T going to try to control the middle of the map. 15 seconds till Dragon is up. Baron has come off the map. Thieb is going to find a bit of a route, but Black Shield stops that. TP in.
Whoa, he's trying to cut him off here, but I don't know if he can catch him. Altec actually on the run too. Can they save him?
Overextended. The heal's not going to be enough. He goes down once more.
That is such poor timing for Cloud9 because they would have had Dragon.
And big damage into Bijou. This might not be a good fight for C19. Moore will get the stun, but in comes the fight towards the back line. Xiaowei forced two Zonias, but huge damage comes out from Ryze. But there comes Vasili on the back lines. The big burst comes across. Bijou barely staying alive. Ryze still in the mix, but the damage is too much. Everyone falling over from C19. LMQ win another huge fight, 4-0.
Yeah, Altec got caught at the worst time possible. Dragon had just spawned, and Vasili was top lane. He had to recall to base and walk all the way down there to join that fight. That would have been a pretty easy dragon for Cloud9 because they had five in the area. But Altec does get caught really early here, and that's going to cost them this entire team fight. He does everything he can to get away, but there's no hope for him. Xiaowei Shao is farmed at the moment, able to finish him off before the heals are able to save his life. And as we know, this changed into a very successful fight for LMQ.
So Baron's now up in 45 seconds, roughly. You got the mid lane pushed down. Looks like LMQ going to get their lanes under control before they set up the Baron pit too much. But keep in mind, this team is up about 13,000 gold. So any sort of open field fight is likely to go very, very well for the Chinese team.
Yeah, man, they got that dragon at the perfect time. That pick onto Altec, circling around behind him, was exactly what LMQ were looking for. They've got such a substantial gold lead that it doesn't really matter what the comp from C9 is at this point.
Yeah, you're going to need like 15, 20 minutes before you can kind of equalize that out and say, well, we're both at full builds. Who cares? But that's a long way away.
And it is the Infinity Edge.
Yep.
Vasili is going.
He's going damage
hard.
9-3 and 6.
By the way, he also flashed into that last fight, into the middle of them.
That's fine. If you're Graves, you can go full womb.
He's a little defensive there. He's got that passive, so
yeah.
It didn't really matter. He had the Xiaowei Shao shield to back him up.
Yeah, and an Orianna. Orianna's one of the best mid laners for defending AD carries.
That's what I said, Xiaowei Shao shield.
Oh yeah, you literally just said that. I was like, and the Orianna! It's like, yeah, freak. Again, the thought popped into my head, I couldn't not say it. It's like bad joke.
You're a genius. You had the exact same thought. They've got the black shield, and they've also got the Orianna shield.
The robot
shield. So, Altec going to opt to use that summoner teleport to his advantage in the late game.
A bit of a catch in a Xiaowei Shao.
They need him to teleport in, though. It's a team fight.
Ackman goes in right in the front lines.
Oh,
Kez dies immediately. 1-0. Now the cleanup crew, LMQ pushing forward. Cocoon not going to land, but Bishu's got really nowhere to go right there. There's the rappel. No Name will find more engages. Bijou now forced to run away. He's going to go down to this one. The bottom lane
That's
turret under fire.
That
but yeah,
is
2-0.
So your teleport split pushing AD carry does not work if you guys are going into a team fight right when he hits the bottom lane. As you said before, Kez not tanky at all yet. Still very squishy. They can take him out of it very quickly. Vasili wants some vengeance here. Can he catch Altec before he finishes the recall? No, he cannot. However, his team will still secure the Baron. Another huge win for LMQ. Cloud9 not really able to work around with their teleport, not split pushing and avoiding the team fight. They're split pushing and getting the team fight. Five versus four.
Yeah, so some great play by LMQ. They're actually getting the catches despite no super traditional like hard crowd control, no Leona, nothing like a Diana or whatever. It's just like, yeah, you know, Renekton, Morgana, Ori, Elise, that's enough. We'll land the skill shots, we'll land the shockwaves. And it's working out for LMQ. They're getting those fights that they want.
Yeah, I mean, theoretically, it should work out for Cloud9 because, you know, they've got the speed boost from their support. They've got a Mikhail's on the support as well, so he can cleanse anyone who gets snared. But it didn't work out for them this time, and now they've got a long, long defensive route ahead of them. Try and defend the inhibitor turrets.
Yeah. Well, aside from gold, for what it's worth, CNNT has an equal turret score, so whichever team gets map control has kind of equal footing and in pushing into the base, but of course that's LMQ by a lot.
They still have two teleports also.
Well, LMQ look to the mid lane right now. It's going to be the recall from Ryze. Yasuke going to keep himself safe. Xiaowei Shao actually being patient with this one. holding towards the bottom lane for now. Mm-hmm. LMQ definitely not rushing off this Baron buff.
Yeah, because the Altec was able to split push, shove it up that far. He drew Xiao Xiao away, using up a little bit of time of that Baron buff. Every second does count for Cloud9.
So here we go. Mid lane a bit under fire. Silence on the no name. He's safe though. Ulti pops by Karma.
Xiao Xiao farms race as usual. Comes in.
It's a double lift of mid lane.
386, yes. There's no mystery where he gets it though.
It's the jungle. He's stealing money from No Name.
Yeah, he was actually stealing that money from Kez.
Yep, that's true.
That was their jungle.
Either jungler. Well,
oh, more!
To start this one out, huge health loss onto Morgana, but it's not going to be much. Gleave Glarber loses even more though. Message sent by LMQ. And he's also done Bishu in a bad spot. Shockwave comes in. Bishu about to fall. Ignite is going to seal the deal. 1-0 so far. Fight continuing. Kez forced to flash backwards, but still taking the burst. Another kill picked up for Vasili. Yeski forced away. The fight still going in. Vasili staying alive. Audit looks for the trade. Not going to find it. Mikhail's keeps him safe. Vasili life steals up rather rapidly off a minion wave, and the mid lane turret is going to be going down. Another 2-0. LMQ now dismantling the base.
That should be at least one inhibitor. Probably get another turret off this one. Two members down from Cloud9. Means that LMQ have the run of the map. They can get anything they want. Since there's no Dragon and no Baron, I'd expect another shove, but they don't want to backdoor anything. The turrets are very, very tanky without minions there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it looks like two of them want a backdoor.
Well, they're poking at it. Yep,
it's not gonna, doesn't help that much because it'll regen. They're getting good damage down on it, though. If they had everybody.
Well, there they go.
And call him in.
Kalin comes in, some decent damage there. One third on the turret health, gonna start regenning, but it's super low. The wave is right about here, but the respawns come in for C9T. A 5-5 Baron buff still on LMQ right now. Will they find the engage? Ulti popped in by Karma. They're gonna go for this one, actually. Some good damage coming across. Will they find much more for this one? There we go. Kez does fall. The fight continuing now, as Bishu's also gonna drop 2-0 LMQ. Altec forced to run back. The dive in by Ackerman. Can he find Yazki? Nice Randuin slow. The ball onto him. They're gonna find the stun. A double kill now for Vasili. 13-3-9 on Graves. A huge fight now for LMQ. The bottom inhibitor gonna go down as well. This could be the tied up series.
All right, Vasili and LMQ strike back. Winning game number two here, going on the Nexus turrets.
And it's gonna be turret number one going down, turret number two soon to follow as well. 36-36 into the game. Teleport comes in just for fun by Altec. Wants to show these two out the summoner spell left, but the Nexus falls over. A 30-minute game, and LMQ in fairly convincing fashion take game two and tie up the series.
Exciting game two as well.
Yeah.
Coming out.
A lot of kills.
Now the reason that I was talking about Soraka being the snowbally champion, we saw it there in those team fights. When she gets behind, you know, she likes to be in the middle of the team fights. That's how she dominates the team fights. She heals everyone up, constant star calls. But if she's behind, then she's squishing those team fights. She can't be that close. She gets sucked in, and they kill her off very easily. Just
yeah.
Because they had so much more money, so much more damage. If you're able to take her out at the beginning, then it's going to be a pretty easy win for the team fight.
Yeah, and speaking of taking her out, I mean, the shockwaves from Xiao Wei Xiao were so good. He's fighting against a bunch of heals. He's fighting against an AD carry with a dash and things like that, and he's still landing them. There's one big crucial team fight for, like, the first dragon where he caught Altec mid-dash, actually. Caught him at the edge of it. The placement of the ball, the ulti's coming through. Those always work so well for Xiao Wei Xiao. Seems that comfort pick picked into the matchup again, said no big deal, we'll play it one more time, and you saw how well his Orianna went.
Yeah, this is really, really fun series to watch. I feel like this is brewing into a good rivalry between